ready to work it out in your favor. He led Ezekiel to the valley of dry bones. Check this out, y'all. The Bible declares, and he calls Ezekiel to pass round about them, and behold, there were many in the open valley, and they were very dry. And he said unto Ezekiel, now notice this, have you ever been in a situation where God knows the answer, but he still questions you? Can these bones live? And Ezekiel, he raises the answer back to God. He said, God, you know. In your situation that you go through, there's only one person that really knows the outcome before the outcome in comes into the income. And that's because of the fact that God, he knew you before he formed you in your mother's womb. And he ordained your steps. And that's why the Bible says that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Because God already wrote your story before you even came into the world. So therefore, when he asks you a question, the best thing you can say is, God, you know. God, I don't know it all. I ain't got it all together. God, I still make mistakes, but God, one person that I do know, he knows how to do everything. He can do exceedingly and abundantly above all I can ever ask or think. He's the only one that can keep me from falling and still present me faultless before the presence of his glory. He's the only one that can make a way out of no way. Ezekiel said, God, you know, and because you know, what do you want me to do? The Lord came to Ezekiel and said, Ezekiel, what I need you to do is open up your mouth and begin to prophesy to this situation. Can I preach to somebody? I got 10 more minutes. Check this out. Here it is. He said, prophesy to this situation. And Ezekiel said, Lord, I'm going to do what you told me to do. And Ezekiel opened up his mouth and said, thus saith the Lord God unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into your body, and ye shall live. Can I preach and tell somebody that all God is doing is waiting on you to open up your mouth and begin to speak some things to your dry situation? You ain't got to stay there. You ain't got to waddle in it. You ain't got to squirm in it. But all you got to do is learn how to open up your mouth and begin to speak to this situation, and that thing ain't got no choice but to change. God says all you got to do is open up your mouth and say, thus saith the Lord. Now here it is. The problem with many of us, why ain't nothing changing in our life, is because we're speaking with thus saith us and not with thus saith the Lord. The reason why you're going through what you're going through is because God ain't speaking to all of us at the same time. But every now and then when God does speak, you gotta learn how to open up your mouth and say what the Lord has spoken to your situation. God told you you were gonna come out of this, but as long as you never speak it, you stay in that mess. God told you you're gonna be delivered, but if you never speak deliverance to your situation, then you'll always be defeated instead of delivered. God told you he was going to raise you up, but if you keep letting the world tear you down, then that's when you're going to stay down and out. If God told you that you shall be healed, but you keep letting the doctors put everything on you, and keep letting the world tell you that you're never going to come out of this, because this issue most people die from. Well, even if I do die, I serve a God that can raise me up. I serve a God. I've been dead before, y'all. Can I preach this for a moment? I've been dead before. I've been spiritually dead, and God stepped into my life and changed me and may life come back into my body. And some of us up in here today have sat here and we're dead sometimes, not having any life in our body. But I come to be like Ezekiel today and tell you that these bones can live, and God can raise you back up, and God can do a new thing in your life. All you gotta do is open up your mouth and begin to speak with the say of the Lord. The Bible declares that after Ezekiel prophesied, there come a noise and a shaking. And I just want to dare somebody up in here, when you get in your dry situation, to open up your mouth and begin to make some noise in your situation. Because when the noise comes, that's when the Lord can show up. When you open up your mouth and stop letting the devil shut you up, then the noise can come and God can show up. When you stop allowing folks to tear you down and know that God created you to be the head and not the tail, then the Lord can show up in your life. And I just dare somebody up in this place to make up in your mind, I'm going to begin to speak to my situation. I'm not going to let my situation tear me down. I'm not going to let my situation run me out. I'm not going to let my situation kill me. But I just believe that if I open up my mouth and say what thus saith the Lord, then the Lord will show up in my situation. He'll work it out in my favor. And I know that I can triumph over the tricks of the enemy. Here it is. Check this out. The Bible declares that after the noise came, there was a shaking. Yeah. Mm. Acts chapter 16 talks about Paul and Silas.
Yes.
And they sang in the midst of being locked up.
Yep. Yeah.
I want to go somewhere with that.
Yes.
They sang in the midst of being locked up. Open that door for me for a second. Because I want the world to hear the noise that's getting ready to come. Because the noise has called, the world has called us to be silent.
Yes.
But if the world understands the power that we really have on the inside.
Yes.
Paul and Silas understood that even in the midst of being locked up, that don't mean I got to shut up. Even in the midst of being down, that don't mean I have to calm down. Even in the midst of everybody counting me out, that don't mean I gotta push God out. Because literally in the midst of me being locked up, I understand that Paul and Silas sang and praised God in the midst of their storm. And the Bible declares that after they begin to sing and after they begin to pray, an earthquake came. And that means simply this, that when the Lord gets ready to show up, all he's waiting on is for you to release a noise that will cause him to, oh, can I pray for more and tell you that at the horse races, the horses don't come out of the stable until a noise begins to happen. The gun goes off and immediately, or the bell is rung, and then the horses begin to run. And God told me to tell you that he's just waiting on you to ring something so that he can be loosed and be free to move on your behalf. God said simply this, when Paul and Silas were locked up, they began to make some noise. The prophet Ezekiel began to make some noise. And in that upper room on the day of Pentecost, the Bible declares that after they made a noise, the Bible came through like a mighty rushing wind, and the Spirit began to fall on all men, and they began to speak in an unknown tongue. And I just dare somebody to make up in your mind, I've had enough examples of folks making noise, and now if I want God to move on my behalf, I got to learn how to, oh, bless the Lord, oh, my soul, and all that's within me. I got to learn how to open up my mouth and begin to magnify the Lord, even if I ain't got nobody talking with me. I got to understand that I can be bipolar at a moment and just have me, myself, and I, and say that when two or more are gathered in his name, he shall be in the midst. I just believe that somebody up in this place needs to wake up in your mind. I'm not going to let my situation kill me, but I'm going to learn how to speak into my life. And I've got to wait on the preacher to prophesy to me, but I can prophesy to myself. Self, you are blessed. Self, you're more than a conqueror. Self, all things are going to work together for your good. Is there anybody up in here that's ready to speak some things that are not as though they are? Anybody ready to open up your mouth and begin to give God some praise? Anybody ready to praise the Lord at all times and his praises? Shouting tears and tears in my mouth. Who am I talking to? That's ready to feel a shaking going on in my life. I need God to shake me, to release some stuff that's connected to me. I need God to shake me, to put some things back in order that have fell out of order. I need God to shake me in order to revive me and make me wake up, because I've been dead too long. Is there anybody up in here that's tired of living a dry life and you need God to rain on you? I need God to pick me up, turn me around, and plant my feet on solid ground. I need God to show up in my life. I need God to work it out in my favor. I need God to deliver me right now, because my valley's been dry. But I just believe if God can show up in Ezekiel, then he can show up in my life. Is there anybody up in here that's ready for God to show up?